Have you ever wondered why there isn't a grate or screen in front of an aircraft's engines to prevent birds from going into it? I'm going to explain it all. Coming up. Hey 7-4 crew, welcome back. If you don't know me, my name's Kelsey. I'm a 747 pilot. My channel, 7-4 Gear, is all about aviation. Today I'm here at Incheon, South Korea, and this is a view from my room. Alright, let's get into the video. After the Hollywood vs. Reality video that I did on the Sully movie, I had a lot of comments and questions from people asking why isn't there something in front of the aircraft's engine to prevent birds from actually taking down an aircraft? And now, I'm sure a lot of you, if you saw a bird on takeoff, you would be like, In this video, I'm going to explain why they don't put something in front of the engines. Let's get into it. It's very natural to wonder why haven't the engineers put something in front of these engines to prevent the birds from actually going in there. I saw a lot of comments, people saying you should put a screen door, you should put grates, you should put lasers.
Frickin' laser beams!
First, I'm going to talk about why you can't put something in front of the engine. If you remember the video that I did where I explained how a jet engine works, you'll remember the engines are actually sucking in a lot of air. So if you're putting a grate or a screen in front of that engine, it's going to prevent a lot of airflow from getting into the engine, and it won't be working very fuel efficiently. The more air that can get sucked into that engine, the more air that can be compressed, mixed with fuel, and actually burned and pushed out the back of the aircraft, which is what pushes it forward. If you follow me on Instagram, you've seen a lot of the stories that I put up on the 747-8 engines, and a lot of pictures and stories because I think they look so cool. And while those engines are very large, they're not even as big as the engines that are on a Boeing 777. But our engines, each individual one, is about $25 million. So you would think they'd put something in there to prevent them because a bunch of geese or birds going into the engine is obviously going to ruin its value. Of course, if you were a pilot and Matt Damon, you would just fly around the birds.
You know what a great pilot would have done? Not hit the birds. That's what I do every day, not hit birds.
Another thing to consider is the majority of birds that I've encountered in flight have been below 3,000 feet above the ground level of that given airport. And the majority of flight time I've experienced is obviously above 3,000 feet. Now take an 8-hour flight as an example, one that I just did a few weeks ago from Charleston, South Carolina to Anchorage, Alaska. We were below 3,000 feet for just a few minutes. So if the whole time above 3,000 feet, our engines are not able to perform fuel efficiently because they have something that is blocking the air from going in there, you're going to burn a lot more gas. Now, while the engineers can't design something to prevent the birds from going into the engine, they have come up with a technology in the event there is a bird strike on takeoff, which is one of the most important times of an aircraft's flight. There is technology now on newer aircraft, for example, on the Boeing 777, where if it were to ingest a bird during takeoff and it were to kill the engine, the computer systems are able to prevent the aircraft from getting into a dangerous situation. The plane's computer actually adjusts for the imbalance in thrust that is being created on both sides of the aircraft. An easy way to understand this technology is imagine you're driving your car down the road and the front left tire were to go flat. The car is going to want to veer to the left. The same thing applies for your aircraft. If on takeoff the aircraft is going down the middle of the runway and it were to lose the left engine from a bird strike or an engine failure, the plane is going to want to veer to the left. This new technology, what it does is it anticipates the difference in imbalance and thrust to help keep the plane going straight down the runway.
That is so baller.
That is exactly what this technology does that's being put on newer aircraft like the Boeing 777. Is there a way to prevent birds from going into an aircraft's engines? No, but engineers are always looking for ways to improve safety in aviation. And the reality is, it's extremely rare for birds to go into an aircraft's engine. In the thousands of hours that I've had, I think I've only had one actually make it into the engine of an aircraft. And all commercial aircraft that you will fly in as a passenger have two engines, and one of those engines is able to have enough power to provide for the plane to actually come back in and land again safely at that airport. Now, if your plane ingests birds in both engines, like Sully and Jeff decided to do, well, then there's not much you can do. But if you're a pilot and you're thinking, oh, I'm gonna come in and land on a Hudson, it's a lot less impressive the second time. If you want to understand more about how an engine works, I'll put a video here where I explain about the two different types of engines on a commercial aircraft. I look forward to hearing from you. Until then, keep the blue side up.